Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. I'm Shubham and you're watching Let Create an App. So in this video, we are going to talk about one of the important topics of any iOS application development, and that is what is user defaults. So user default is kind of a data storage which is used to store data in the application, and that data will stay even after the application get terminated or you going to restart the application. So basically user default is used to store small amount of data, just like 100 KB. And if the data is more than 100 KB, then we need to use some other data storage, just like core data or realm database, something like that. In user defaults, we can store just like a user settings, properties, some kind of a properties, flags, just like this kind of a things. So in this tutorial, we are going to save the state of the switch so that application gets restarted. It will hold the state of that switch. So let's look into the demo first, and then we will see how we can create this kind of functionality. So this is the demo app in which the initial stage is false. Now let's on this thing and just move on home and just remove this thing. So let's move on this again. So it will return us true the previous state. It will hold the previous state. And if we change the state again of this switch. So now let's move again home. And now let's remove this thing again like this. And this will hold the previous state again. So we are going to create this thing in this demo. So we are going to create this thing in this video. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. So let's start the video. Let's create an app. So open an Xcode, click on single view application, click on next and give the whatever name you want to give. I'm just giving user defaults. Demo like this and create this project where you want to create. I'm creating this project on my desktop. Now let's move on the storyboard and create a basic layout which we have seen in the demo application. So I'm quickly designing this thing. So our design is ready. Now we have to take the outlets of all these elements on view controller. So just move on the view controller by doing this thing. And now let's take our outlet of this switch first. So like switch test like this, and this is apply label. LBL, and we have to take the action of the switch also, so that whenever user change the switch properties, that action will be called. So on click switch like this. So we have taken all the things. Now we can only need to do some coding part. So we don't need this storyboard. So let's only move on the view controller like this and remove this thing. So our basic things are ready. Now we have to take one class which will extend user defaults. And that class is only responsible for holding all the keys. We only need to call the methods of that class so that we don't need to remember the key every time. We only need to call these methods, and the keys are mentioned in the method itself. So let's take one class, and it's a Swift class. Now just the name should be like user defaults plus extension. So because it's an extension of a user defaults, now we have to define like extension user defaults like this. And in this we have to define one method like function set value for switch. So whenever we set any value for switch, we will call this method. And in this we have to pass the value parameter which is of bool type like this, and it should be an optional because user can pass nil also in this method, so that if he wants to remove the value from the user default, they can simply pass nil in this thing, and this will automatically remove the object from the user default. So now if we have to check one thing, that value is not equals to nil like this, and in this we have to set the user default. So user defaults dot standard dot value for key, set value for key set. So there are different methods in user defaults. There we can define any kind of method. For integer we can use this, for float this one, double this one, but we can also use any if we don't need if we don't know what kind of value will be stored. Definitely we will know in this demo example, but sometimes we don't know, so we can simply use this method. And in this we have to save the value like this. And for key it's like switch state, So this is a key. So whenever we want to get this value again, we need to remember this key every time. So that's why I'm putting this thing in a single place. And whenever we require to get this value or save this value again, we only need to call this method with the value. So we don't need to remember this key every time. And in the else part, if the user passed nil in this thing, then we have to remove this object. Dot remove object like this, and in this we have to simply copy this thing and paste over here. So simply like this. Now we have to do one more thing. We have to forcefully update the user defaults. Basically, user defaults update itself automatically periodically, but if we want to manually update the user defaults, then we can do like user defaults dot standard dot synchronize method. So this method can be called and user defaults will automatically update with every key. Now we have to create one more method to get this value. We have just set the value, now we have to get this value. So function get value of switch like this, and in this it will simply return a bool value. So this will return a bool value like this, and it should be an optional. Now we have to return the user default value. So for that, user default dot standard dot value for key, and in this we have to pass the key which we have to copy from over here like this, and we have to type pass this thing in bool because this function will return a bool value. So maybe this can be an issue. So we have to type cast this thing in bool. So this is a user default class, and as we know, user default is just like a key value pair. So this is a key, and with respect to this key, the data is saved. So we only need to remember this key, and even we are using three times this key, so we can also create one global variable or constant variable, and then we can define this key in that constant variable and use that constant variable over here. So this is also we can do like. Now let's move on the view controller. Now we have to initially, when the view did load, we have to check that what is the value of that key at that initial state. On the basis of that, we will set the value of that switch. So for that, first let's get the value of that user default or that key. So for that, we have to just write if let. Now we have to get that value. So let user default value is equals to user default dot standard. Now we will get the method which we have created over there. So first get value for key, get value for switch. So we will get this method, and this will return a bool value. So we have to, if this is a true, so we have to place a value, user default value over here, user default value. So if there is a true in this statement, this will return true, then this method will be execute, else this method will be execute. So if the statement is true, then what we have to do, we have to change the switch to on state. So switch test dot set on, and in this we have to pass the value. We can also use user default value, or we can simply directly pass true over here, and in the animation we have to pass true like this. And one more thing we have to do, like we have to change the label text. So label dot text is equals to true like this. T should be capital. So like this, we can also execute the else part. So for that, we have to switch test dot set on, and in this we have to pass the false like this, and the animation is true. And for label text, we have to pass false over here like this. Now we have to manage this switch over here, and for that we have to just create it same thing which we have done at the top. So now first we have to change this any to UI switch, because this is an action of switch. So this will sender will give the state of that switch. So for like if sender dot is on, means if the sender is on, if the switch is on, this block of code will execute, else this block of code will execute. Now if the switch state will be changes, then we have to change the value in the user default also. So for that, user default dot standard dot set value for key. So this one set value for switch, and in this we have to pass the state. So if the state is true, then this this block will be executed. Means current position of the switch is true. Now we have to change the position to false. So we have to send the false over here like this, and we have to do two more things, that we have to change the switch switch values also. So for that we have to pass false over here, and the animation is also true. One more thing, label value will also change. So label dot text is equals to false, and we have to copy this thing just, and wherever we are using a true value, we have to just change it to false. So like false over here, we have to use true. Sorry, this is also true, and here also true, like this. Now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. So let's run this thing. So basically using user default is very easy, but this is the correct way to use the user default, and it will also make things very easy to use. So the current state of our user default is false because our switch is off. Now let's change the state to true. Now let's terminate the application. So for terminating the application, I'm switching off this application because we don't need this thing anymore. We can simply test over here like this. So previously we have stored this thing with true, so it will maintain the state. Now let's make it false and just move home, and we have to clean this thing. So just clean this thing. So this is my demo which I worked on. So let's run this thing again, and it is again in false state. Now let's run this thing, make it true again, and just move on home and terminate this thing and run again. So it is true. So it is maintaining its own state. Whatever we are saving in this switch, it will automatically take that thing and store in the application itself. So this is for today. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. Thank you.